Okay, there we go. Game two. Miss Raven versus Raven. 1-0 for her. I'm not gonna cry to sleep tonight. I am not. It's you, not me. Okay, but that is a game two conversion, right? I talk a lot about game two conversion, so we're gonna go game two conversion. And I know where to go. Would you like to go first? No. I need to target Ditto or a Grimma first. And come on. Ugh. I'm going second. She does not have a Marshadow. Okay, I should be fine. I don't want to be Guzmad. Or I don't want her to use Guzma. I still want some escape ropes. Those escape ropes, man. Those escape ropes. Okay, guys. So who are you cheering for? If I'm gonna win, I'm gonna post a code in the chat. So, you know. You want to cheer for Raven? Oh, come on. Really? A second Jolteon? Wow. That's a rude hand. Ditto. Or, okay, it's a Grimma. Okay, that is, you know, just putting everything on the line. Cynthia. Ah, almost. Literally almost. Uh-oh. If there's gonna be Mook now. Actually, you know what? No. I can overcome Mook. So he definitely she plays a little bit different than she plays IRL. Because IRL, that would be, you know, a straightforward Lele into Elm's Lecture into full bench, basically, of Zoruas. Jesus, this is a completely different strategy. Which I really do not like. Okay. Jolteon. Okay, Tapu Koko with a dance. Yeah, let's go for supporter and I'm gonna go for Lola. I chose Lola just in case. But if she has a Guzma, I'm dead. Or close to death. Oh, this is stressful. Like, you play all those games, like, oh yeah, that's fun, you know, it's nice. But when you have, you know, like. Yeah. She's playing mind games. Cynthia. Okay, wait. I'm gonna do a dance. I know that's not a lot, but we've got this in play. We've got a Thunder Mountain in play. That's only 3 energy, but if she's gonna use a GX attack, it's gonna be 150, which is not enough. And I still can use the ability. Okay, Oranguru instruct. I have to just look out at my bench. Like, I can't put a lot of things on my bench. So that's a Sky High Claws and pass the turn. Because this is the main attacker. If I'm gonna get rid of this, I should be fine. Because we do not have weakness, we don't have any resistance as well. I think it would be cool to just, you know, for you guys to spectate the game from her perspective, or to be able to see what she has in hand. That would be really interesting. Communication for Mook or Zoroark. I think more for Mook. And I kind of have to stop. I know what she's playing. I know the list. I know the list. Okay, this is not. Oh, this is not her IRL list. This is the list that won in Brazil, actually, during a special event. I believe that the deck won. Like, won one of those, you know, one of the two special events that were happening last weekend. Because she did do not play this Zoroark IRL, so this indicates me like, hey, this is this version. Because I know I've sent the version of the deck to her today. Elms Lecture, yeah. Oh boy. So, like now, like really, now you see me thinking super hard on my next moves. Because she can deal 110. That's 150. Okay, I don't have to worry about that move. And now, okay, now the Thunder is gonna come. So Volkner, going for Ultra Ball. No Ultra Ball. No Ultra Ball. Okay, so I need a different strategy now. And the strategy is gonna be called Jolteon. Right? So I'm gonna go Jolteon. Because now I'm safe. Now I can play anything I want on my bench. I know this is gonna get knocked out. Or actually, I can wait. I can retreat it. Play the GX move. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, I'm gonna retreat. And play the GX move of my own. So, don't show it again. There we go. And we got Dumbles. Dumbles in this deck are only, the only purpose of Dumbles is for Jolteon. And I know I have to play the Aether Paradise next turn. There's no other way. I think we have this game. I think this game is ours. I might get too cocky, but I think this is gonna be our game. But dude, Rema, you're a great coach, by the way. You're a great coach. Come on. There we go. Okay. Now, the machine will. Okay, so first things first. To be honest, what I can do is play Guzma and get this guy up front. That's what I'm gonna do. Oh, they're amazing, dude. Okay, so now there's gonna go energy, Aether Paradise. Oh yeah. Like that's the thing when I'm playing against Lycanroc deck. When the first phase, or the phase with the GX move, when I'm gonna survive the GX attack, I'm okay, because now I can play a bench. And this is a huge problem against Zorak, because I really you tend to control I tend to control it more than online, to be honest. Okay, one, two, so two more DCE and around six energy in a deck, and then six more fighting type energy. Okay, so that is, search for a DCE. I caught myself recently that even IRL, I do not get the sarcasm. Really, even IRL, I have huge problems with the sarcasm. But yeah, I'm not a really good reader of people. Like I always think I've done something wrong, and like I'm always, always scared that I, done something to someone. So yeah, you're an amazing person and you're helping me a lot. Thank you. And King Yoshi, you too, and others, Skoto, love you too. You're all amazing. Don't forget about that. And escape rope. Huh. That's 100 damage. Yeah. We're still alive. Best of three. If I'm gonna win, this is gonna be a best of three. Okay, Guzma for Jolteon. Oh, Coco. Yeah, right, Coco. Okay, I have my own Guzma. I should be able to knock it out, right? Yep. So flying flip for the knockout. I hate how close this is. And don't let Kovac bully. I will not. I'll try not to let her bully me. Have a fantastic day, my friend. Have an amazing day. And you know, hope the work is gonna just pass by super fast. And yeah, have a great work. Thanks for being here. Stay amazing, my friend. Stay amazing. Love ya. Mwah. And then after the stream, I'm posting the video with deck. Like I said, all comes down to this. Trade 15. Dumbbells? Like, the correct play would be, you know, dumbbells and choice band, and that's what happened. I still have one more dumbbells, because I know I play a pair off. So there are still dumbbells in the deck. And I knock out. Okay. So it all comes down to this. So if I'm gonna play Electro Bullet right here, basically they're both gonna be in range. So Electro Bullet, and they're both gonna be in range of my Head Bolt. That is the only play I could have done right now, just preparing those two guys, and that's it. Lily, so no, excuse me, no Guzma. Thank goodness, no Guzma. Oh boy. Four cards. I think we're gonna see a retreat for the Zoroark. Like, at least that's what I would do, just a retreat to play the Zoroark with one energy. I know she listens, so I'm giving her advice, but it all depends on energy. But that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's still one energy floating around. Trade. Oh, that is cocky. That is a cocky trade. And there's a DCE. So yeah, we're gonna see a retreat, and this little guy is gonna be played. Erika's hospitality. Oof. Well, definitely Elan Mook is annoying right now, to be quite honest. So I'm gonna retreat for freehand play, Tapu Lele. Do we still have a Guzma? No. Nah, it's gonna be a GG. Well, I can wait. I can stall the game. Ha ha ha. I can try to stall the game. Because I can play Coco, retreat. Yeah, I can stall the game. I can actually stall the game. Okay, there goes Acerola. But it does not matter. It does not matter. Yeah, we've won. I've actually won. Yep, she's gonna be one turn too short. One turn too short. Just in case. Bam! Last card. Come on. You don't have Guzma. I know you don't. You played all three. You played three just like me. Yep. So the trading won the game for me. Oof. You say game two conversion, I always say that, and that's exactly what happened. Ugh. Done. There we go. That was a hard fought victory. Hard fought victory. So going into game three, ladies and gentlemen, going into game three, we are 1-1 against Miss Raven Kovac, better half of Pokemon couple. So let's go into game three, shall we?